We're in northern Italy now, at the border of Austria and Slovenia, in the Valcanale. The city of Tavisio extends between the Carnic Alps and the Caravan Ranges in the north and the Julian Alps in the south. Back in 2003, Tavisio was the host city for the 21st Winter Universiade. 10 years later, what is the legacy of the Winter Universiade to Tavisio? And what kind of place was it before organising the event? Well, Renato Calatoni says Tavisio has always been a fairly touristic ski resort with Monte Lasari. It's the place of pilgrimage for people you can find here, Italians, Austrians and Slovenians. And it's been a regular venue for alpine skiing over the years. So a lot had to be done, though, for the FASU's requirements for the city of Tavisio. It had to raise huge funds, helped by the region of Friuli Venezia Giulia, in order to go from a small ski resort to an international winter sports competition venue. Maurizio says regarding the sports facilities, ski lifts, ice stadiums, ski jumping hills, cross-country tracks, curling and club, there's been a remarkable investment. And all those investments helped Tavisio increase its skiing area standard, but also extended its influence over the area, being surrounded by Slovenia and Austria, making it the centre of winter sports in the province. Just in Tavisio, we have 38 kilometres of alpine skiing slopes, not mentioning the Nordic skiing tracks nearby in Selenovia. There are another 35 kilometres, and 10 kilometres from Tavisio, we're connected with Slovenia, which means you can spend the day skiing in both Italy and Slovenia. And it's a frontier area with no real boundaries. Naturally, the higher standards and larger skiing area change the tourist statistics. The cost of a day's skiing is one of the most attractive in the region, even compared to their foreign neighbours. What's the impact then on the tourism figures since 2003? Well, it has completely changed. It made Tavisio famous. We have a lot of tourists coming here to the area. If we compare the statistics from the 90s, we've increased it by 150% to our present-day figures in the district. So everything was born in Tavisio 2003. But the legacy is not only about figures and facilities. The combination of the two made it possible for Tavisio to host other high-level winter sports competitions. Thanks also to the Winter Universiade, some forgotten disciplines were revived. Well, the 2003 Winter Universiade was a great springboard for other sports and events. We had a lot of other events held here since then, the most important being the Women's Alpine Skiing World Cup Leg. And we've been hosting that for 3 years now. We entered this network with high satisfaction, so that will be a major result from that. But we mustn't forget the other disciplines. We hosted the Nordic Skiing Juniors and the Under 23 World Championships in 2007 in ice hockey. The team of Ponteba has been revived and is now playing in Serie 1 in Italy. And fair results as well in club. The province of Pordenone, where curling has been revived, has started to do really well. So overall, we have this great return to sports at the highest level. The feeling that we have now, 10 years after the Universiade, is that we have made a lot of initiatives about different winter sports. They have been born or reborn. And it means that the interest of the public and also the interest of the students to practice these sports has just grown bigger and bigger. The flame of the Winter Universiade still burns in Tavisio 10 years after the city hosted the event, and it will remain for local people and organisers a tremendous memory as much as a real springboard to excellence.